Hola, 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 buenos dias, good morning, beautiful planner babes, welcome back to the channel. It's your girl here, Daniela, the planning diva. Long time no see, haven't uploaded in a minute here. Life has been super busy. I went to New Mexico for a work conference, and the time leading up to the conference, the time at the conference, and the time coming back after the conference has been insanely busy for me. So that's where I've been, but I'm so happy to be back and right in time to start all of our July start planners. So please let me know what planners you're moving into this month. It's such an exciting time in the planner community. Today, I actually wanted to update my work planner. I wanted to do a quick flip through of my work planner. I need to update it. I need to reorganize it. I just need to get this planner together because I am moving into a new planner, new planners, and I wanted to set up my work planner on camera with you all because I thought it would be fun to just, you know, film a video and also show you a very real process in my life. And I also wanted to flip through my work planner and share with you all how it's been looking for the first half of the year. So I started off this year with the Cozy Critters big vertical planner. It's super, super cute. I have some stickers here that I made on the inside cover. Just a pretty standard cover page. I do use the year at a glance here and there, but pretty sparingly. I love the monthly currently pages, like the monthly overview pages. These pages are probably some of my favorite pages that Happy Planner has come out with in terms of the overview page. And then I just have one of these floral Mickey and Minnie dividers separating the different sections in my work planner. And I actually had research and teaching planners Franken-planned into this one work planner. So that's why I have this divider here. I have the research divider and then the teaching divider. But honestly, I haven't been teaching as much as I thought I would be this past year, so my teaching section has been kind of sparse. I have been using it here and there when I was teaching an online course, and I also use the teaching section for my own personal education and professional development and career development that isn't necessarily tied to like my actual scientific research. So that's how I've been using the teaching section as well. So any professional development, workshops, trainings would go into that teaching section because I use that section as like a teaching myself section as well. But honestly, right now, my work planner is a bit of a mess because I was shifting it around for the upcoming conference. I didn't take the teaching section because I wasn't going to be, you know, teaching or doing any other type of teaching activities during the conference. So I pulled all of those pages out. And I actually have them here next to me. And I really need to just reorganize this thing now that I'm back. But anyways, let's get through the flip through. So we have January. Very, very cute. I use the monthlies pretty sparingly. This was the first week of the year and I wasn't in here. I was on vacation. And then this is the week I got COVID. So I was also not in here. And then I started getting back into work this week. And I use this planner very much like a workhorse, a workspace. It's not pretty, it's messy, and it is blank at times. I write down notes, I write down to-dos, I write down meetings. I like using these pages as note dumps. This was a seminar I attended about pest control, and yeah. I'm also going to be pulling out these pages as we go through because I want to put these away. And then we have February. I love this divider so much. I'm definitely going to be holding on to these dividers. So again, month is kind of sparse. I use the pages very much like a brain dump at times. So these are all notes from a seminar I went to. And honestly, my work planner is a little bit ugly at times. Like, look at this. But that's because it is a work planner. Oh, this is a week I actually tried to make it look cute. I was using the colorful leopard sticker book. I like to use the sidebar as like a goal section. This one, I was using a color storybook, the indigo style. Very, very cute. And then again, I use this page for note dump. Let me pull that out. And then we have March. I'm definitely holding on to these dividers. They're so cute. I was sprinkling my lemon stickers over everything at this point. And again, the month section, I go back and forth with using them. And sometimes I do use them, sometimes I don't. And then this sticker book is super cute. I forget what sticker book this is. I think it may be like the Boss Babe sticker book. This is pressed florals. Sometimes I decorate a lot and then I don't write in it. So that was one of those instances. This is another one of the color story, books, the indigo spread. I really like the pops of blue against the yellow. Again, we're using the Hustle Hard sticker book or the Boss Babe sticker book. That one was nice. And then here I was using sophisticated florals. This is a week I really wasn't in my planner past Wednesday. It happens. And then again, notes on the overview page. So let me pull March out. And then we have April. I made this sticker for my research team when we went out to work in the apiary. And, you know, wrote some things here and there, but nothing too crazy. This was when I was at the PEC branch conference in Seattle, so I really wasn't in here. And then I tried getting back into my planner this week, and I was in here for the first half of the week, and then I wasn't for the second half. And then I am using the sophisticated florals sticker book a lot this month, trying to finish it. I actually did finish it this week. I just really wasn't in here too much, so nothing happened there. And then no notes on the May overview. Then we have May. Some things written down here on the monthly. Oops, nothing going on this first week. And this week was also pretty blank. And then I got really into it in mid-May. Just have a lot of notes here. And then I was having a lot of fun with the Colorful Dog sticker book. This is one of the sticker books I'm trying to finish this year. So I was using it a lot. And then we have the June overview, which I actually didn't write on. And then we have June with the cute little birds. I have my bookmark here for the monthly, and then this is a sticker I got at the Evolution conference that I was at last week. It was such an intense conference. I'm so exhausted from it. But again, this monthly, it was sparsely used, but I really was using the weeklies quite a bit at this point. So that was fun. I was really getting into it. And then this week, I have my sticky notes here. I tried getting into here and I wasn't really in here. This was the Conference for Evolution. It was a lot of fun. It was a great conference. I'm very happy about it. And this is the current week. And we're actually switching into our new planners this week. So I'm so excited. So I'm gonna pull this out. And I've actually decided that I want to hold on to these pages. I don't usually hold on to my work planners, but I'm feeling pretty attached to this work planner. I feel like I'm starting to settle into the rhythm of work planner life. And I really like some of the spreads in here. I like the memories. I also have lots of notes from seminars I have attended and just helpful tips for myself. And so I think I'm going to hold on to these. And I'm going to try to hold on to my work planners from now on and just keep them in my office because they are full of good notes and like tips and tricks for different like analyses and names of people, researchers, notes on papers that I've read. And so I think I am going to hold on to these pages. Okay, so I've decided that I am going to use the Squad Girls big vertical planner for work. I went ahead and picked up the Squad Girls big planner. I was back and forth with this planner. I am on a no buy, so I definitely broke my no buy for this, but I just could not resist this gorgeous, gorgeous planner. I love the multicolored pastel plaid on the inside covers. I think that is so gorgeous. Love this cover page. Love the decoration, the colors, the fonts, and I really like a colorful and decorated planner for work because sometimes I don't decorate them as much, and so having the decorations and the fun fonts and the fun colors for the numbers really makes me happy. And I think this is going to be such a perfect work planner. I'm very excited about this. And so I picked that up and I popped in July in here already. And actually, I think what I'm going to do now is I am going to pull out the title page here. I think I'm ready to let go of this one. So I'm going to pull out this cover page here, pop it in, and I'm going to pull out these cover pages and year at a glance. And I'm going to pull out this cover page and the calendars in the front. I don't think I will keep this cover page. I don't know. Maybe I'll keep this cover page. Yeah, I think I'll keep this cover page for, future use. I'm gonna get rid of these year at a glances. And before I get rid of these, I'm gonna quickly write down the things that I've written down on some of these here. So I need to write down like the stuff that I wrote for later on in the year. So let me quickly do that. Okay, so I've written down everything that I've wanted to write down. So we can get rid of these pages. And then moving on, I kind of want to pull this out, like the research section. I don't think I need it anymore. So then we can jump straight into July here. And I haven't set up anything in the monthly, but I have started writing down some things, putting down some stickers for earlier this week. It's currently the 28th, so I wrote down some meetings that I had. And yeah, I'm breaking into this little by little. Oh, this is a vision board. I love this. I kind of want to keep this, but I'm not sure where to put it. Let's see. Maybe I should put it here, like in the middle of the year at a glance. I want to make this a vision board for work. So I still am thinking about what to do with that, but that will be a future project. Okay, and then, oh my goodness, y'all. So I have July, and then let me grab the Squad Girls planner here. So I'm thinking of putting in the rest of the year, like from July through December. How cute. This is such a cute planner. And then moving into my teaching plan. I just love the seasonal. Ugh, it's amazing. I wasn't immediately drawn to the Squad Girls release when it first came out, but then I hung out with my planner bestie Rachel from Rach Makes a Plan, and she was showing me the one of the classic squad planners, and they had exactly the same like dividers as the big. And it was so freaking cute that I was convinced. I was convinced. I was sold. Honestly, I was a little tired of the cozy critters and I wanted something different. And this is just absolutely perfection. It's so cute. So I'm gonna have 6 months in here, July through December. And then I'm going to switch into my teaching planner, which at first I wasn't sure if I was going to keep with a teaching planner for my work planner. Before I had my research and my teaching planners kind of frankenplanned into this one work planner. And I was actually using the Paula and the Waffle planner. And this was the teaching divider that I have here. And I was actually using a mix of like a Whimsy Wonders Mickey Mouse teaching planner and the Paul and Waffle. So yeah, it's kind of a mess right now. but I wasn't sure if I was going to be using a teaching planner because I really wasn't using the teaching planner as much as I thought I was going to be using it. More so in the weeks that I was teaching, I did teach a semester course, virtually though. But as I said, I use the teaching planner as my own professional development, career development, educational development as well. So I was using it even if I wasn't teaching or actively teaching. That being said, I was thinking about potentially just merging the two together and then using more like daily pages and blank notebook pages for my teaching section. But then I accepted a job offer to be an in-person teacher in San Diego prison. So I've been teaching in the correctional facilities since 2018, I believe. I was teaching in person in jail, and then when COVID happened, all programming stopped and I was teaching virtually for a while. And on top of that, I've been involved in numerous efforts trying to develop programming for other correctional facilities. And I'm still involved in that, but I haven't been actively teaching in person since before the pandemic. I have taught virtually through the prison education project, but again, that's all been through Zoom. But I recently accepted a job to teach in San Diego prison. It's an in-person position, and it's actually an art course. It's not a science course. So I actually start today. Today is my first day. It's an evening course, and it's only one day per week. But I will be driving down to San Diego prison later today to teach my first in-person course since before the pandemic. And so I'm super, super excited about that. And I didn't leave my current job. I am still a postdoc at UC Riverside. And this teaching position is definitely not full-time, it's part-time. So it's going to be definitely manageable for me, but you will likely see a lower amount of videos from me because I have another job now. Anyways, I decided to celebrate by getting a teaching planner. This is from the new back to school release, and I just love this cover so much. It says, "Messy classrooms are where the magic happens." And I'm actually thinking of making this like a transformer planner and then clipping in this cover here. Like so. So we have here the calendar, which I'll pull these pages here, pop this in. This is such a fun planner. I think it's so cute. And this is a teaching planner. It's very neutral, like in the pages and in the monthly calendars. So I'm excited about this. We have August, amazing. September, be a highlight in someone's day. October, it's okay to make mistakes. November, make your students smile today. December, one child, one teacher, one book, and one pen can change the world. This is very much geared towards, I feel like, elementary, middle school, and I teach adult prisoners, but that's fine. So I have 6 months in here, and then I have my notes section, which I'm thinking it'll be nice to put this school is cool divider. I kind of want to peel this off. I've used undo to peel that off. So this is going to be my notes section. And I think I'm going to pull out these notes, the ones that I've written on. And I'm going to tuck these into the previous months from my work planner and just save these as well. Let's see. I'm going to pull these out as well. I do have some of these half sheets, which I think I might get rid of those. And then I have some stickers in here, which I'm going to pull these out. I brought these for the conference. So I just, oh, what's this? Oh, someone gave me these at conference. Okay, I have this little pack of like stickers and some notes and a diagram that I like to reference. So I might put that there. And then also, I took these out when I went to the conference, but I want to put these back in. Oops, I have some random stickers. These are just like different types of stationery that I like to use for work. So let me see. I'm going to tuck them in here. like so. Perfect. Oop. And then I have my whiteboard, which I'm thinking I could tuck my whiteboard in here. And then, let's see. Actually, no. Let me pull this out, this whiteboard. And then maybe I could put it right after my research section. Okay. So I have my teaching section, notes, my folder, scratch. I'm kind of tired of this divider, so I'm going to move it away from now. I have notes here. I'm going to put those with the other notes that I took out. These are all note pages. Okay, I'm going to leave the note pages in here. And I have some like daily schedules here. Okay, actually, I think I'm going to get rid of these daily pages, or I'm just going to set them aside for later use, because right now I'm really loving my daily planner, so I haven't really been using these daily pages as much as I want to. So we're just going to have, let me move this folder here. So we're just going to have note pages and then the folder at the back. Okay, so I think we're all set here. Oh, and I'm going to change the cover from the Cozy Critters to Squad Girls. Oh, I have a bunch of papers here. So I will pull this out too. Okay, so we have Squad Girls. Beautiful. I love this so much. This pastel paisley gingham. I love it. And then we have my Cozy Critters vision board, the year at a glance, the year at a glance. And then we have July. A beautiful, 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 beautiful. August, September, October, November. This will take me to the end of the year. I have my Cozy Critters whiteboard here. And then my transformer planner, messy classrooms are where the magic happens. My cover page, year at a glance, the detailed year at a glance. And then we have July, and it's going to be a teacher layout. August, September, October, November, December. And this is also going to take me to the end of the year. And then we just have a divider here. School is cool. And a bunch of blank note pages. These are from Cozy Critters. These are from the Whimsy Wonders, Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Whimsy Wonders. And then these are from a Villains accessory pack. And then lastly, my Cozy Critters folder with some stationery and some other thing, useful things. And actually, I kind of want to pop in this divider right here, or this cover right here. Does that wait? So that way it's very clear where my teaching planner begins and ends. And then we have my research planner. And then when I want to use a different cover, focus on my teaching, I have my teaching planner right here. Oops. I feel like I'm not doing this right. I guess this one needs to go right here. So that way it's like this. And then like this. Okay, that makes a lot more sense. Yeah, that makes a lot more sense. So I have my research planner here, and then I have my teaching planner here. And I guess one last thing, I kind of want to have my notes after my research planner. So I'll pull these out and pop these in right here. Perfect. Okay, and then the very last thing that I need to do is put in my bookmarks. So I'm going to pop in a bookmark for the monthly. And right now the bookmarks I've been using are these three, but I kind of want to add two more. Okay, I think I'm going to go with these two. So where I want to add my bookmarks. Okay, I love this one so much. This is just a plain polka dot one, but I added this amazing Smokey Bear sticker to it. This one, this is where I work the most, my weekly research planner. So I'll put that one there. I also want to put one on the monthly, and I'm thinking for the monthly, it'll be this pink one that says, do what they think you cannot do. Ugh, and let me get rid of these little stickies, these little like stickers I put at the tabs. Actually, I changed my mind with this one. I should use my Squad Girls bookmark. So I'll put that one for the monthly. I do want to use a bookmark for my year at a glance, like this one right here. I want to have a better habit of like flipping to this section and checking out what is coming up in the future. So those are the three bookmarks I want in this section. And then in my teaching section, I don't really care about having a bookmark for this year at a glance. And honestly, I don't think I will use this year at a glance. I think I might just put everything in the first year at a glance. Use this Squad of Girls year at a glance for both research and teaching. And then not use this one. Okay, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and commit to that. Like, I will pull out these pages, tape these two together. Like so. Okay, so there we go. Now that's together. So it goes straight into July. And then this is where I want to add these bookmarks. I want one in the monthly. I'm going to use this super cute pink one. And then I'll use this Mickey Mouse one. This Whimsy Wonders bookmark for the weekly, which is where I like to flip to the most. And then I am going to add these Winnie the Pooh sticky notes for this section. And then I'll add these wild styled sticky notes for this section right here. I'll put them on front like so. Okay, and I think we're done. This is it. I wonder if I want to continue using this hardcover work-life balance cover thing. I found this planner at my thrift store for like $3, and so I bought it just so I could use this hardcover. I feel like it does protect my planner quite a bit, so I think I will keep on using this cover. I was afraid it might be a little too wonky with the transformer planner, but I could always like pull it out, transform it, and then put it back in. This is it. I'm happy with this. Okay, everyone, thank you so much for checking out this video. I really appreciate it. I hope you're having a wonderful time playing in your planners. Let me know what planners you're moving into this week. I would love to know. And with that, I hope to see you in my next video. So until then, stay safe, stay blessed, and happy planning. Adios.